Hello all, this is Shashank here. So I am here to just give a brief demo on CyberArk PS solution. Right? So we are here to discuss the importance of privileged account security, okay, which is termed as PAS. Privileged account security, which is termed as PAS solution. So what is meant by privileged account security? So we have many number of privileged accounts across all organizations. Okay, so in order to protect all these privileged accounts, we need a particular or a automation tool which secures our account passwords in a local repository, right? In this PAS solution, the emerging technologies or the emerging tools are CyberArk, Beyond Trust, Tycotic, so etc., whatever it is. So the emerging tools, in that CyberArk is the most commonly used product for the PS solution. Now let's go into it. Before going to the privileged access security or account security, what is meant by privileged account? So privileged account, in the sense, it is a user account, it's a general user account which has more privileges than ordinary users, okay? And also it is referred as keys to the kingdom. Let me explain in a real-time scenario. So users will be operating in the software industry, users will be interacting with the desktops or laptops or Windows or whatever servers. So for each operating system, we have a particular account which we log in into the operating system. So a particular account which has full rights or more privileges or which contains sensitive information is termed as a privileged account, right? So let's take an example. So I have a laptop, and by default, for my Windows operating system, I have an administrator account, right? So with this administrator account, I can be able to install or remove any additional software or upgrade my operating system or whatever I can do. I can modify the system configuration with my administrator account. So this administrator account has full permissions, has full or privileges on the operating system. So this account, this administrator account, is termed as a privileged account. In a similar way, we can also create multiple accounts based on our usage, and we can grant administrative access for that account. So then that account will be termed as a privileged account, right? So now, privileged account exists every connected device, database, application, everywhere. Privileged accounts exist everywhere, right? So now our agenda is, our agenda for the CyberArk PAS solution is to manage the most privileged accounts and SSH keys in our enterprise. So beyond that SSH keys, we mostly prefer privileged accounts. We focus on the privileged accounts only, right? Now, this PAS solution can also be termed as PIM or PAM solution. PIM is nothing but privileged identity management, and PAM is nothing but privileged account management. So in this three terminologies, PIM, PAS, or PAM, we can see a common terminology called privilege. So we are here to organize or to secure our privileged account passwords, right? So privileged accounts are termed as the keys to the kingdom, because we just look into our operating system, we will just store our important data, you know, laptops or desktops or whatever it is. Now if we get access to that particular account, the unknown access person get access to that account, if he knows the password, he can log into that with that account, and he can grab the data, he can or leak the data from that system. So that is why privileged accounts are termed as keys to the kingdom. Now, privileged accounts, in the sense, by default, for every Windows server, we have an administrator account, and for every Unix servers, we have a root and sysadmin as a privileged account. For databases, we have Oracle as a privileged account, and for every Cisco device, we have Cisco enable account as a default privileged account. Now, so here in privileged access security, this solution enables the organization to secure, manage, control, and monitor all activities for the privileged account. So there are four functionalities for this PS solution. So the first one is secure, manage, control, and monitor. So we'll just know what each functionality does. Now, the first one, secure. So we'll just secure our all the passwords in a local repository or a local database for the which is connected to that solution. Okay, we'll just secure our passwords, right? Next, manage, in the sense passwords will be rotated frequently. So these passwords are non-human interactive. So human, generally, if this solution is not used, if this privileged account security is not used, we'll just change our passwords and we'll just manage our passwords with human mind. Let's say if we just store a password like ASDF123, so it can be remembered by human. ASDF123. This password can be remembered by human. So this password can be known to other persons by any chance, by when we are typing or by interacting with other persons like that. So when we manage the passwords with an automation tool, this password can be managed by a particular solution so that humans cannot remember, and we will get complex passwords. So in this way, we'll manage our passwords. And also control. Control, in the sense, we'll just grant access to only specific persons who can use the passwords and not all the persons, right? Let's say if a manager is using an account, so he only can check out the password, take the password from that solution, and he can only use the account password, and nobody can, no other members can access that password. So we can control the access control. And also monitor, in the sense all the activities for the privileged accounts can be monitored. So that password, let's say a user has used the password 6 times a day, so all the 6 activities will be monitored and stored as in the form of activities related to that account. So we can track the password usage also. So that is what mean by monitor. So these 4 functionalities can be provided by privileged access security, right? So why privileged account security? Why it is necessary? If you go here, now passwords act as the keys to the kingdom. Privileged account passwords act as the keys to the kingdom. So these passwords are easy to crack, and there are many tools which are readily available for the hackers in order to hack the password. Okay, so now password is nothing but a secret that allows to use an account, right? For an administrator account, we'll set a password and we'll enter that password in order to log in with that account, right? Now, so most of the non-human do not represent human beings, in the sense application accounts, right? Application accounts are used by many number of persons, not a single person. It's not a user account. Let's say if there is an application running in an organization and all the team members related to the application will use that account password. So multiple users can use that password. So it can be shared by IT staff. So if this password is maintained out of privileged access security, okay, this can be shared with multiple persons and we cannot track whoever used the password at what time. But if we can secure our password in this privileged access security CyberArk, we can track which user used the password at what time. So we can all track all the activities. So examples of privileged accounts as discussed, we have local admin accounts in Windows servers, domain admin accounts in Active Directory for the LDAP, and for databases we have SA, system admin accounts, and for Unix we have root accounts as discussed, right? Now, there is a common attack method which is used frequently, which is called Mimikatz. Mimikatz is a widely used tool by hackers in order to know the password. Let's take an example. So a user is using an account in this server to access the data. Now, the attacker or the hacker will, what he does, he will just send some unknown hashes. Hash is nothing but an encrypted representation of password. He does not know the password, but even though he will just send an encrypted representation of a password, just like an unknown password, then the system, the local subsystem authority, right, local security authority subsystem will detect that hash and it will think that, oh yeah, this is my owner, he just needs the password, and what it does, it just provides the password to the attacker. So attackers will use this widely used tools, mimickers tools, in order to know the password. So we also have here mimikatz. Yeah, this mimikatz, the usage of the mimikatz tool is nothing but we call it as pass the hash attack, since hashes are passed, right? Yeah. Next. So typically, in an organization, for every one employee, there exist 3 privileged accounts at least, because every employee works on different applications or different, he does multiple tasks. So for every task or for every application work, he uses a privileged account in order to complete that work. So for every employee, there exists at least 3 privileged accounts. So example, if 100 employees exist in that organization, we will have at least 300 privileged accounts migrating in the organization, navigating in the organization. So there is our responsibility in order to protect all the privileged accounts. This CyberArk PS solution utilizes, it provides digital vault in order to store the password securely in a local repository, right? And this digital vault is called as the heart of the privileged account security solution, right? In order to secure these passwords in vault, it uses a concept like hardened, in the sense nobody can enter into the vault indirectly without a CyberArk authentication or whatever authentication. And no third-party applications can be installed on that where vault is installed, on the server where vault is installed, right? So why? So next, why CyberArk? Why we need to use only CyberArk? There are n number of tools or products available for the privileged account security. Like as discussed, we have Beyond Trust and Tycotic. Also, we have CA technologies mostly using. Right, but why we need to use only CyberArk when compared with the other tools? Because more than half of Fortune 500 companies trust CyberArk. There is a list called Fortune 500 companies where US just gives a list every year with the top companies. So more than half of the Fortune 500 companies trust CyberArk in order to protect their privileged account passwords. So that is why the reason we are migrating into CyberArk, or we navigate into CyberArk. Now, what are the software prerequisites in order to host our CyberArk environment? So this CyberArk software can be installed on Windows 2008 or Windows 2012 R2 OS. So only this operating system is supported. Next, and also we need a web server of IIS. Since IIS is a Microsoft one, so CyberArk recommend IIS web server, right? And also for web browser, so IE is compatible and recommended. And we need there is a dependency code of .NET framework, because CyberArk software is developed entirely on .NET language. So while installing the CyberArk product or CyberArk components, .NET framework is a mandatory to install before we install all the products. Next, let's take an example. Before CyberArk, this is an organization. This is a map of an organization where existing access persons, or that means the persons who already exist in the organization and who enters newly, will just come into the organization and they move laterally within the network. Within the organization, they will move laterally without knowing to each other. They will just use the passwords at whatever time they want. What they want to do, they will do everything, but there is no tracking process of what user is doing what work. Now, when CyberArk is deployed in the organization, so it acts like a barrier. Okay, so now the already the existing person and also the new person enters, the external person and the internal person both has to enter into CyberArk in order to move into the in the organization. That means when they enter into the organization, if they want to do any work, if they want to use a account, any account password, they need to enter into CyberArk. They need to check out the password from CyberArk, and they can do their work later on. Now, by doing so, everything or every account password can be tracked, whoever used that password, right? So next, so in this privileged access security or account security, we have totally of 6 modules or 6 products available, right? So the first one is EPV, which is termed as Enterprise Password Vault. Now let's split this words, Enterprise Password Vault. So all the passwords are related to enterprise or organization are stored in a vault. So this, hence they named it as Enterprise Password Vault. So this EPV or Enterprise Password Vault is the heart of the privileged access security. So at most, we need to deploy this product first, and later the remaining products or components can be installed later. The second one is Privileged Session Manager. So after storing the password securely and after using the passwords by the users, if you want to record the sessions for which users are using the passwords, how they use, we can record the sessions, we can monitor the sessions also using this PSM component, Privileged Session Manager, right? We can record the sessions. Next. And also we have PTA, which is termed as Privileged Threat Analytics. In the sense, it is analytics, it is a data visualization product where we can analyze the data of whenever users want to use the password or want to log in into CyberArk in an unknown times, or if they want to do a brute force attack. This threat analytics product can detect and give an alert to the CyberArk administrators that, hey, this user is an unknown person who wants to try to log in into CyberArk in an unknown time or whatever the rules we set. And apart from the account passwords, we can also store application passwords with the use of Application Identity Manager. Let's take, for every application, we have a configuration file wherein in every configuration file, there exists a username and password in that file, right? So this file can be opened by any person and the username and password can be known. But in order to decrease that mitigation rule, we are using this AIM, Application Identity Manager, in order to secure the application passwords securely in the vault also. And also, in order to maintain the least privilege concept, we are using OPM and DPM as the advanced products. So these 6 modules fulfill the privileged access security solution. Okay, so this is a brief description of every module or every component of privileged access security, right? EPV, in the sense, it enables organizations to secure, manage, and log all activities for the privileged passwords. And AIM, what AIM does is, it addresses the challenge of hard-coded app-to-app credentials, right? So let's take an example. We have an application called SAILPOINT. It's an IDM application. So it is hosted on a web server called Apache Tomcat, wherein, so the username and password while running the SAILPOINT application in the web server, we need a username and password internally. So it uses a file, properties file called IAQ property, IAQ file. So in this property file, there exists a username and password by default. Username and password. So this username and password can be managed by CyberArk using AIM module. Okay, right. So PSM, in a sense, it monitors and records, or it provides session recording for all the privileged account passwords, right? And also PTA, OPM, and DPM are the advanced one. Now, what are the benefits of using the PAS solution? So the first one is, we can set main policy rules that define how all the privileged accounts in our organization can be managed. this can, this policy rules can be set by master policy. We have a concept called master policy wherein we can set all the policy rules, how we can manage account passwords, right? And also we can manage and protect the passwords, control access, and we can monitor as discussed. And this CyberArk is very easy to set up and deploy. And we have regulatory requirements like SOX, HIPAA, and PCI DSS tools. So this CyberArk solution can comply, or it is benefitable with this, compatible with this regulatory systems also. Next. So in the core module, in the starting of the first module EPV, there exists four components. The first one is Vault, which is called Digital Vault, right? Digital Vault, wherein passwords are secured in this vault. Next, CPM, which is termed as Central Policy Manager. I just write it over here. Vault. Okay. And the second one is CPM, which is termed as Central Policy Manager, which is an automation engine for managing all the passwords in CyberArk. So this CPM is responsible to manage all the account passwords. And the third one is PVWA. This is an interface which represents the vault in web. This PWA component is termed as password vault web access. So in order to represent, in order to provide this interface in this vault to end users directly through web, we use this PWA component. This is an interface. And also we have a thick application called Private Arc Client. Private Arc Client. This is also an interface which is used only by administrators in order to perform configuration tasks. Admins. Okay. So this PWA and Private Arc are nothing but interfaces in order to represent or view the vault. Right? Next. So in the core solution, we have a secure digital vault, which is a hardened and secured server to store all the privilege account information or passwords. Next, CPM is defined as Central Policy Manager, which performs the password changes for every privileged account, and PWA, which is termed as Password Vault Web Access. It is a web interface for users to gain access. In order to check out the passwords, they use PWA component. And Private Arc Client is a thick client application used by administrators to perform configuration tasks, right? So first we have secure digital vault, right? This digital vault is used to store the privileged account, and all the activities for the accounts, passwords will be stored here, and the configuration data is provided for the most components. So CPM. So CPM role is to change passwords based on the organization requirements. So we'll just gather the requirements of the organization, how passwords can be changed, and we'll just set it over here based on policy rules, which is called master policy. So based on this master policy, CPM changes the passwords for all the privileged accounts. So hence it is known as policy-based password management, and it is automatic. Right. Next, PWA, which is termed as Password Vault Web Access. It is a web interface, right, which is used by end users to gain access. They will log into this component and they will check out the passwords of whatever account they want, if they have access, right? So going over here. So we have multiple security layers within CyberArk, or from the vault to the end user perspective, there exist 7 security layers which act in between in order to secure the passwords. So the first one is firewall and code data isolation. So we know by default in a Windows operating system, we have a Windows firewall. In a similar way, for CyberArk, we have a CyberArk oriented or CyberArk hardened Windows firewall, right? So there exists a service like CyberArk hardened firewall, which blocks all the ports, unnecessary ports on the particular server where vault exists. So it only allows a particular port named 1858, which is called vault protocol. So the communication to the vault can only be done by the port number 1858, which is called as vault protocol. So all the unnecessary ports except 1858 will be blocked using this firewall. So authentication. So in order to authenticate to CyberArk, CyberArk provides different types of authentication methods like RSA Secure ID, Radius authentications, Windows authentication, and PKI digital certificates. So based on whatever authentication we want, we can just access or log in to CyberArk with that particular authentication. Next, access control. So this access control is a built-in mechanism wherein CyberArk uses a terminology called safes. There is a terminology called safes wherein access is controlled for all the privileged account passwords. We'll get into it later. Password file encryption. Every password is stored in vault in an encrypted format. So every password is stored in vault is encrypted and using an encryption algorithm. By default, CyberArk uses. So as we know, in encryption and decryption mechanism, we have two types. Symmetric encryption and asymmetric encryption, right? So for symmetric encryption, CyberArk uses AES 256-bit standard, 256-bit standard algorithm for symmetric encryption. So AES stands for Advanced Encryption Standard. For asymmetric encryption, CyberArk uses RSA 2048 algorithm for asymmetric encryption. So as we know, just give me a brief introduction about symmetric and asymmetric encryption. Symmetric in the sense, it uses only one key in order to encrypt and decrypt an account password. So asymmetric in the sense, there exist two keys, public key and private key. Public key and private key together for the encryption and decryption process. So for this asymmetric encryption, CyberArk product uses RSA 2048 algorithm, and for symmetric it uses AES 256 algorithm, right? Now, visual security. So all the account activities can be monitored and can be viewed in a real time visually using visual security layer, and there is also called manual security, which we can enable dual control access. In the sense, if a user wants to access a password, we can set certain approvals for the password. If and only the approvals are completed, an end user can use a password. So we can also set manual security. There is a manual security layer also for geographical security. Based on geographical location, we can set access for the users, right? So these are all the security layers available. Now, so vault protects our passwords based on the timing restrictions. In the sense, let's take an organization which works from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. So they can set only this specific timings, wherein users can check out the passwords or use the passwords in this period of time. Apart from this time, they cannot use the passwords. So this timing restrictions can protect our passwords, which is in the vault. And based on protected network area, which is maintained by geographical security and access control, we can control the access for the passwords, and all the activities can be monitored in the auditing process. And we can set dual control as discussed based on approvals in order to access the password, and all the activity logs can be recorded, right? So what are the interfaces available in this privileged account security? We have PWA and private client as interfaces. CPM is an engine, password engine, which changes the passwords frequently, right? access control. Before going to that, let's move over here. Now, how passwords are changed in the device? So, first of all, based on organization requirement, we just set policy definitions or policy rules in CyberArk. So, based on that policy rules, CPM changes the password. It generates a new complex password and changes it, the password in the IT environment, like in the target device, and it puts the same password in the vault. So CPM manages this vault and the target device from the both ends. From one end, it manages the vault password, and on the other end, it manages the also the target password, target account password. So both the passwords must be in sync state in order to use the password, right? End users, what they will do, they will just log into PWA component and they will check out the password from vault. So PWA is nothing but a representation of vault. So all the passwords are represented in PWA. They will just log into PWA and they will check out the password from PWA and they will log in directly to the target accounts. So this is the architecture. Right? So access control. So access control determines that who can access the information or privileged accounts and from where. So this can be done by a concept called safes. This, our digital vault, gives us a flexibility to organize accounts or to segregate accounts based on our requirements and store them in different safes. So we can segregate, we can create multiple safes in a vault, and we can put or we can store a particular password in a particular safe. So based on that safe, we'll just grant access to that password. Let's take a real-time scenario. We have a club or So let's take a club. So members who want to enter the club, first they want to register and they need to be a club member in order to enter into the club. In the same way, users want to access the password which is stored in the safe. First they need to be a safe member. So safe member is nothing but users who have access to safes are called safe members. Let's take an example. I have an administrator account and I have stored it in a safe called, I have a safe called admin safe, and I stored the password securely, administrator account password securely in that admin safe. Now a user, an unknown user XYZ, want to access this administrator account. So first of all, he must be a member of this safe. So CyberArk administrators will add that user into the safe. Then he can use the account password which is stored in that safe. That is what it is. Okay. And also we can set different types of permissions. Based on the permissions, user can use the password in a different way. So not all the users will get the same access. Based on the permissions they get, or permissions we give, they can use the password based on that permission. So by there are totally 22 permissions by default for the safe member, but I have written here a sample pass permissions. So there's a permission called use accounts in which we can use the account password without knowing that password, and retrieve accounts, in the sense this is a permission in which we can retrieve the password, and in the sense we can know the password what it is, right? And update account content is the sense this permission can be given to managers, wherein they can update the account content also. They can update the account properties or account password also. Next, initiate CPM account management operation, in the sense the users which we give this permission can initiate CPM operations, right? So what are CPM operations? There are three types of CPM operations. Okay, verify, change, and reconcile. So there are three CPM management operations. So, I wrote it here. So there are three password management processes or CPM processes. Okay, so the first one is verify. If we initiate or trigger verify operation or verify process, CPM verifies the password at both ends. The first end it takes the password from Vault and it verifies whether that the same password exists on the target device or not. So it verifies the password. Next, change. If we initiate the change process, password will be changed. CPM generates a new password and a new password. That new password will be replaced at both ends. It will be replaced in the Vault and also on the target machine. So end user can log in into CyberArk and check out the new password and can he can use the password. Reconcile in the sense, it is a reset process wherein if passwords are not in sync state, when passwords are in unsync state or we have unknown passwords at both ends, we can use this reconcile operation or process in order to change the password or reset the password successfully. So let's take in a real-time example. We have a Facebook account and if we forgot a password, if we don't know our password, we'll just click forgot password and we'll just reset our password. Am I right? In the same manner, reconcile operation is used to reset our password for that privileged account. Okay. So this is it regarding the demo class of CyberArk. So I want to show any other. So the account management lifecycle, CyberArk, so not only CyberArk, for the privileged access security, there is a account management lifecycle wherein, first of all, we need to create our privileged accounts. Okay, after creating our privileged accounts in the operating system or database or whatever device type, next we need to store that privileged passwords securely in privileged access security solution, that is CyberArk. Next, after storing this privileged account passwords, we need to grant access to that passwords and set up permissions. After setting the permissions to the user, user can log into CyberArk and he can use the password at whatever time he wants through a particular workflow. Next, after the usage of the password, this password must immediately be changed, because once the password is used, it must be changed immediately in order to generate a new password wherein other user can use that new password for that account. And we need to review or monitor logs or activities regularly in a frequent interval of time in order to see that all the things are going in a smooth manner, that nobody are using an unknown passwords or whatever time frame it is. We need to review. So there are create, store, access, use, rotate, and review. This is the life cycle process of the privileged account management. Right. So thanks guys for the demo class. Hope guys you understood the importance of privileged accounts, passwords, and we are using CyberArk in order to secure our privileged account passwords. Right. Thank you.